wine country. This is wine country. And because of that, we wanted a product that would go along with the wineries. We do not own a vineyard. We're not rich people. And so we weren't able to create, you know, our own wine label. But we have a product that goes along with the wine, and that's what we wanted to do. We knew that we were going to have a hit right off when we first started this business. I am not the one that actually invented the idea of a wine slush, but I perfected it. And that's where I think we shine, is because we have taken an idea that we saw years ago and made it even better than what it is.
So for a business owner that's unrelated to what you're doing, the idea of taking an idea and actually executing it with some excellence, and how do you do that? How do you perfect some? How do you take something to the next level?
Well, for us, again, we use the demographic of our area. So that worked for us. Now, a totally different business, I think it's more of loving what you do, loving your product, and being creative. Once you're creative, you know everything about that product, and I think that really enhances your whole business. Because if you're going to buy and sell something, it's not the same. If you are the creator, you're the one that knows every step of that business. When you talk to your customers, you can explain that, and they see it. They understand that you really do love your product, that you are proud of your product, and that, to me, is 90% of the business.
And then in your industry and what you do, what does innovation look like? How do you innovate in your industry?
How do you mean innovate? You
mean, well, they improve a product or you change a product. Maybe for you, it's just coming up with new, interesting flavors. I don't know.
Well, yes and no. And I'll give you that's a great example. One of our best flavors was called strawberry pomegranate. And this summer, we were playing around with it, and I thought, what could make one of our better flavors even better? We added rhubarb to it, and people go, rhubarb? But oh my goodness, the flavor is 10 times better than it was before. It's selling so much faster than it was before, just because it's not only strawberry and pomegranate, but there's rhubarb in it. And whatever it was, it just, that extra flavor brought the other two together. And so by experimenting, even with our most popular ones, we've been able to enhance it and make it even better.
Mm-hmm. And so your advice to other business owners along the lines of the importance of stretching themselves or experimenting or trying something a little bit different or new, I mean, how would you impress upon them the importance of doing that?
Don't be afraid. You know, take the risk. If you don't like it, that's fine. Shelf it. But if it is better, it's like, oh my goodness, your business will do so much better. And I think that's why people are in business, because they want it to grow. They don't want to just sit there. They want to expand their business. And also by trying something new, even with a good product that you have, there's nothing wrong with experimenting with it. There's the old expression, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. I don't always believe in that theory, because I think that everything that you have can always be just a little bit better.